Hello everybody, Hooded Cobra Commander 788 here, and I'm back with another vintage G.I. Joe toy review, and this is a review that was requested by a viewer. I am reviewing the 1984 G.I. Joe Halo Jumper Ripcord. Ripcord was introduced in 1984, he was also sold in 1985, he was discontinued in 1986, and in 1987 he had a replacement, Crazy Legs. One interesting little fact, even though this Ripcord is Caucasian, all later versions of Ripcord have been African American, mostly based on Marlon Wayans from the G.I. Joe Rise of Cobra movie. I don't really mind that change so much, but none of the later versions had this vintage look with the camouflage and the realistic paratrooper style to it, and I would kind of like to see an updated version of this vintage first version of Ripcord. That would be really cool. Let's take a look at Ripcord's accessories, and he had a lot of them, and let's start by looking at this mask. This is an air mask for diving from high altitudes for oxygen. It wraps around his helmet, and it fastens with this buckle, sort of, and it has a hose that connects to, oddly enough, to his reserve parachute. I guess there's supposed to be like an air tank inside there, but I mean, that's where his reserve chute is. And it plugs in fairly snugly into this hole in his reserve chute there. You can see the end of the hose and the hose detail, and here you can see the details on the air mask and the goggles. It looks really nice, and this looks a lot like the air mask and hose that came with the 1985 parachute pack. In fact, it may be the same accessory, but I don't have the parachute pack to compare them, so I can't say that for sure. Eventually, I will get a parachute pack, and when I do, I will review it, and I will compare that one to this air mask that came with Ripcord to see if they are in fact the same accessory. The face mask may be slightly undersized for his face, and these straps could be just a little bit longer to reach around the extra thick helmet that he has. Now let's look at that helmet, and this helmet is not the standard G.I. Joe helmet. It's quite a bit different. It has kind of curved sides there, and there is a variation of this helmet. You can find some that have holes in the sides. But this one, of course, doesn't. Now let's look at Ripcord's weapon, and the contents of the card on which he was packaged called this an SLR W1L1 rifle. What this is a green version of the British L1A1 self-loading rifle. In fact, that's what SLR stands for, self-loading rifle. And that rifle is a derivative of the Belgian FN-FAL rifle. And the Belgian rifle has been around since 1954. In fact, the Belgian rifle is extremely widely used. It is used by virtually every NATO country other than the United States. So this is a copy of one of the most widely used rifles in all of history. Other reviewers have suggested that this is not the right rifle for Ripcord. As a paratrooper, he should be carrying something smaller, something more compact and lighter. And this is a very long-barreled rifle for someone who's going to be parachuting behind enemy lines. And I pretty much agree with that criticism. I think that he, for his role, should have a smaller gun. But I would have settled for this gun if it had a strap. I think if it had a strap where you could sling it across his back or something like that, that I think would have improved this in my mind. I really think that's a missed opportunity because obviously he's not going to be parachuting holding his rifle, you know, ready to fire. He's going to need to strap it on himself somehow. Since the rifle doesn't have a strap, an alternative way to carry it is to put it in the strap of the parachute. One criticism I have of this design is that it has a carrying handle, and that's not the criticism. That's kind of cool. But it has this scope right behind the carrying handle, so anyone who looked through that scope would see nothing but the handle. That doesn't really make a whole lot of sense. Despite that fact, this is a great rifle, a great accessory. I love the green. The green really complements the action figure. This is amazing. Now let's take a look at this parachute, and this parachute is amazing. It has some awesome detail. It straps on and connects with this buckle in the back here. You undo that, and this back piece just kind of flips up like that, and you just pull it over his head, and now you have the parachute off. And look how detailed that is. This is just amazing. The sculpting detail on this is mind-blowing. It looks like a parachute. I mean, you can see every little detail in the front and the back. Right here it has sculpted on what looks like an altimeter. Here it has a pouch. It's got some really nice looking buckles. And it even has this cord that runs back here for the ripcord to open the main chute. One thing I don't like is when you have it strapped on like it normally would, the strap goes around the parachute and it kind of covers up some of that amazing sculpted detail. So sometimes when I display it, I put the strap underneath. It does mean that this back portion kind of flips up like that, but I can live with that because you can see the detail much better. The main knock on this accessory is that it's not a real parachute. It's a great looking replica chute for a backpack, but of course it doesn't open up and, you know, actually deploy a parachute. And as we know, G.I. Joe did have some real working parachutes in the line before this came out, but that's not much of a knock because when I was playing with this as a kid, I had no problem with that at all. I can always pretend there's a parachute deploying and that problem was solved. And so I don't want that to be taken as much of a criticism of this. This is a really amazing looking accessory. Let's take a look at the articulation on Ripcord, and he had the typical articulation of 1984 G.I. Joe action figures, which means he could turn his head from left to right like that. He could move his arm at the shoulder about so far, and he could swivel it all the way around. He had a hinge at the elbow, so he could move at the elbow about 90 degrees, and he had a swivel at the bicep, so he could swivel all the way around. The figure was held together with a rubber O-ring that looped around the inside, so he could move at the torso a little bit. He could move his legs apart about so far. He could move his legs at the hip about 90 degrees, and he could bend at the knee about 90 degrees. Let's take a look at the sculpt design and color of Ripcord, and the first thing you notice is that camouflage paint app all the way around from head to toe, and this is awesome. When I was a kid, I loved the realistic military figures, and did I play with this when I was a kid? Yes, I did. Did I love this figure as a kid? Oh yes, I did. This guy got a lot of playtime when I was playing with G.I. Joe as a kid, and you know, he was just on every mission because he looks exactly the way I wanted a G.I. Joe to look. He looks like an army guy ready for combat. Taking a look at Ripcord's head, he is a ginger, or his hair is really kind of a reddish brown, but I'd call that red. I'd say he's a redhead. His face, I would say, is a little less than handsome. He's no Don Johnson, if you know what I mean. But this is nonetheless a really good head sculpt. There's a lot of character in that face. His chest is pretty plain with a couple pockets, no real detail on the back. His arms are also fairly plain, but he has some nice black gloves. Those look pretty good. His waist piece is the most detailed part of the action figure, and it has a sculpted on harness for the parachute, and that continues around to the back. You can see a line here where his shirt is tucked under his belt. His legs are also fairly plain with these very large pockets on either leg that look like they are full of equipment, and that's probably appropriate for a paratrooper. His boots are partially covered by his trouser legs, as you can see here. So this is a pretty plain action figure, not a lot of sculpted detail on him, but I never cared about that. I always loved this action figure. It didn't bother me that it didn't have a lot of details on it. I just think he looks great all by himself. And if you think the action figure is plain, that plainness is more than overcome by the accessories. Let's take another look at the figure with his accessories on. With his accessories on, he doesn't look plain at all. He looks amazing. He looks like a very realistic paratrooper. And this realism I loved as a kid and I still do. Honestly, you could just give me 10 of these guys and I would be happy. I think it's unfortunate that in 1988 with his replacement Crazy Legs, they kind of got away from that a bit and went with some very unrealistic colors with the red and the gray and this kind of checker pattern here. Honestly, between the two, Ripcord by very far is my favorite. Let's take a look at the file card, and this file card was printed on the back of the card on which the figure was packaged. On the flip side, you can see part of the front of the card there. And here it has his portrait, and this is a nice looking portrait. Looks pretty cool. Looks like he's dropping into battle. It has his faction as G.I. Joe. It says he's a Halo jumper, and in parentheses, high altitude, low opening. So that's what Halo stands for. His codename is Ripcord. His file name is Wallace A. Weems. Primary military specialty is airborne infantry. Secondary military specialty, demolitions. Birthplace, Columbus, Ohio, and his grade is E4. In this section, it says, Ripcord joined the Civil Air Patrol in high school, discovered skydiving, and joined the G.I. Joe team so he could jump from much higher altitudes. Qualified expert, M16, M1911A1 auto pistol, Carl Gustav 9mm Parabellum, and Browning High Power. Oddly, it doesn't list him as a qualified expert with the weapon that he actually came with. This bottom section has a quote, but it doesn't say who it's quoting. It says, let's say you got a trouble spot. You can't sail, walk, or ride in, so you send a plane so high that it can't be seen or heard. Ripcord jumps and drops like a rock for thousands of feet, then opens his chute at the last possible moment to avoid visual and electronic detection. What he does once he hits the ground, you don't want to hear about. This file card portrays Ripcord as someone who really fell in love with skydiving from an early age, and that's what he really wants to do. So maybe he's a skydiver first and a soldier second, but it does seem like he's very proficient at his job and he does his job well. In the G.I. Joe comic book, Ripcord was a pretty well-developed character, and he had a major impact on the storyline of G.I. Joe. In the comic book, Ripcord had a girlfriend, Bongo the Balloon Bear. There was never any action figure made of Bongo the Balloon Bear, so this one's just a stand-in. Of course, Bongo the Balloon Bear was not her real name. There was a woman inside the bear costume, and her name was Candy. There was never any action figure made of Candy, so this is just a stand-in. At one point, Ripcord single-handedly invaded Cobra Island looking for Candy, and for a while, he switched places with Zartan. Ripcord was also instrumental in revealing the secret location of the Cobra base in Springfield. Ripcord must have really cared about Candy in order to defy orders to go search for her. Unfortunately, what he didn't know is that Candy had already been murdered by Scrap Iron. That murder went something a little bit like this. It was tragic. Hey, you want to see something that really pisses Ripcord off? Check this out. I'm going to eat candy right in front of him. That's right, Ripcord. Look at me. I'm eating candy. Nom, nom. That's good candy. I could eat this candy all day. What you going to do about it, little man? Nothing. Nothing, because you're made of plastic. Overall, Ripcord is kind of a plain figure, and it would have been nice to see a little bit more sculpted detail, maybe a sidearm or something like that. That would have been nice, but it never really bothered me as a kid, and it doesn't really bother me very much now. I don't think he needs a lot more detail, because he has all of these amazing accessories. To me, this figure is the essence of what G.I. Joe was and what I wanted it to be. These realistic army guys that I could take out in the backyard, and they could actually go on missions and fight Cobra. And actually look good doing it. That was my review of the 1984 Ripcord. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you're thinking of getting a Ripcord, I hope you found it informative. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, because I've got a lot of great new G.I. Joe toy reviews coming up. You do not want to miss them. And don't forget to like the Facebook page. You get a lot of updates there that you don't get anywhere else. Thanks for watching, and Happy New Year, everyone.
He'll fight for freedom wherever there's trouble.
Are those the new Joes, Destro?
Yes, Commander.
Who's on the watchtower?
That's the Jungle Trooper, codename Rakundo.
And manning the howitzer?
That's the Flamethrower, codename Blowtorch. And the Halo Jumper, codename Ripcord.
Who's by the bivouac?
That's the Dog Handler, codename Mutt.